taken in at the three. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
So here's the first drive now for the 49ers.
They'll be led out by the former number 3 overall pick back in 2021. It's Trey Lance.
And just think about what his ceiling in the NFL could be, because when you go back to his one collegiate season as a starter, the full season, he went undefeated, didn't throw an interception, and ran for over 1,000 yards as well. When you see him hit the field, you see a possible superstar in the making.
Right out of the gates, Lance going to the air. That's complete to the tight end, Warner.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. From the 36, Lance. The first catch of the game for George Kittle.
Lance now on first down. That's complete. It's Brandon Ayuk.
Now this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he has met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. And good work there in open space. And he's got this all the way down now to the 32.
And that'll go for a gain of 18 on the keeper. First down.
And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that. And here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game. And all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 32-yard line.
And Lance again going to keep it. And an excellent job of finding the opening as he's got this now all the way down to the 22.
10 more there and another first down.
Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane and he keeps it himself there. Worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. This defense for the Rams, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
There's a little bit of lightning talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
On second down, McCaffrey. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Play number 9 now on this pretty long opening drive. This is third down.
Lance now to throw. Trying for Ayuk, but it's intercepted.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a throwaways. The 20, 10, 5. And he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Lance touchdown.
It's only the first quarter. That's a quick shift in momentum right there because they were driving the football before that interception. And then not only, Charles, did they throw the pick, but it gets returned all the other way for the score.
And the important thing here was it backed up in their own territory. This defense didn't blitz. They hung in there, waited for the offense to make a mistake. And as soon as they did, they capitalized in the biggest way possible.
Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-4. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And not much happening on the return as they'll get this to about the 23.
Back out there comes the 49ers offense ready for their second drive.
Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
They fake the handoff. Now Lance. His throw incomplete. So the incomplete pass on the last play. That leads us to a third and three. Here's Lance. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Good contain. No gain on the screen. And they're bringing up fourth down.
The whole idea of the screen pass is to throw the defense in.
They were four.
Not a second, not one bit. How about them figuring it out, diagnosing it, and spilling it for lost yardage?
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. They punted three times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. So out come the Rams now for their first possession.
They'll be led out by a longtime starter in the NFL, a former number one overall pick way back in 2009. It's Matthew Stafford.
And he said he was feeling good in the lead up to the season, and he proved it in a big way in week one with four touchdown passes. Had the offense moving at peak efficiency right at the start of the year. Awfully impressive.
Stafford and the Rams come up first and 10 at their own 26. They'll begin on the ground with Akers. The numbers for him from a week ago, 15 carries, 62 yards.
It was a pretty mediocre week for him on the ground. Certainly a boon to his offense if he gets a little more output on his touches this week. He should get some more early carries as his team tries to get him into a rhythm.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Now Stafford. Got a man open. It's Tyler Higbee. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. And the Rams are 1-0 on the year following the win in week one. They were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They got the home ground behind them. I think it's going to be tough to beat this one.
11 more yards. That go around. A first down as well.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. The top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs. In this case, the feet. Did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
Yeah, great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. 5 yards. Now it's third and five. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. Here's Stafford. Over the middle, that's home in by Cutt. And not much happening there. He's taken down, but a late penalty flag in the backfield. This looks like a roughing call. A bad time for a roughing penalty, and they get the gift of a first and 10. They'll go with Akers here up the middle. And just a couple yards there down to the 17. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The Rams with the football here to begin the second quarter. As they've got a second and 8 forthcoming. Throwing a Stafford. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Hard throw, incomplete. So on fourth down, Sean McVay going to send out the field goal unit. From the right hash, just a 34-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one score lead, two score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The 49ers ready to set up shop again offensively. Nothing for him yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26. They'll go option to the short side. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. The Niners on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Lance looking to throw it. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line. Had some good yardage there, too, before he fumbled that football, Charles.
Yeah, just think about it this way. Running backs, as a general rule, they kind of know when the end of a run is near. And you notice how they cover up, right? They protect the football. Sometimes quarterbacks forget that out in the open field. After a while, you start to wonder, does the running back coach visit the quarterback coach and say, hey, I can help you with this. We can protect this and make sure we keep the ball.
Following the fumble recovery, Stafford. And his throw here is going to be incomplete. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now it's Stafford. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Fred Warner. And the 49ers force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. So this defense coming up with a takeaway, and maybe that's something that can bring a little life to that sideline.
Well, I don't want to say that they've been sleepwalking through this first half, because that's simply not true, but you're right. We haven't seen a lot of fire from these guys, really, on either side of the ball. So maybe that's the catalyst that they needed to get them back into this game.
Lance and the 49ers now, 1st and 10, at their own 27. And they'll run the option to start the drive. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. On play action, Lance steps away. And his throw is going to be incomplete. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Lance going to throw. Nice call to the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a good call there that brings up 4.
Well, I got the cover for this all breakout on 3rd down. Dive defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed. Unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Rams are going offense here with the 1st and 10. So here are the Rams to take over. They got the victory last week. That was against the Baltimore Ravens, and they have the lead here as well. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw.
He'll get this to Akers out of the backfield.
And he gets this up to the 34, out of bounds there.
Out of bounds at the 34-yard line. It's a gain of 5.
Here's a run with Akers on 2nd down. 7 yards there and a 1st down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Now a 1st down throw, Stafford. Get there.
Nick Bosa so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down.
That's a pretty darn good start to his season, huh? A sack in the opener, adds a 2nd one here. That tells you about his offseason. He came in determined to have a big year, and it's paying off.
work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Now Stafford. That's out to the flat for Akers. It'll go as a gain of four. And they'll be facing a third and 12.
It's a gain of four.
A shotgun snap for Stafford. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only about one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Called out a 41-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10.
And now this offense comes back out onto the field.
And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so. They need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field.
The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And he's going to be swallowed up as he got forward for maybe a yard, and it's second down.
The fumble on first down. Now here's second down. Here's Lance to throw it.
Incomplete.
That's a nice job there, because you got to play the ball, not the man, when it covers. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. He's able to knock that one away.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And it would appear he's going to be short of a first down as he stopped right around the 29. Just a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll be the call to the punt team as it's fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fair catch, signal four, and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And they will take over first and 10. Stafford and the Rams come up first and 10. Just shy of the 30. Stafford. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
It's second down and 10.
They give up the middle to Akers. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and 3.
That's a gain of seven.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Stafford on third down. Forced out to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He gets a first down.
Certainly not a positive sign if you're the D coordinator and you see your guys give up that space so early in the game. Third down, that's when the clamps are supposed to come out. But his ability to create things with his legs makes things difficult.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Stafford. They'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
Good strong throw and catch right there. It's important in this game. The alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. From the 50, Stafford. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. From the 44, Stafford. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and 4. Throwing again is Stafford.
connecting with Kupp here on the out route.
And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
Stafford is number one guy, Kupp, for Los Angeles first.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 35. From the gun, here's Stafford. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Here's Stafford. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And finally down he goes. Jose working inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Now Stafford must not be pleased with something. He's going to turn, and he signals for a timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Stafford now to throw. He's brought down, and remember here, no timeouts left. They got to get to the line quick. So we have reached halftime with our
Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number three. Stafford and the Rams come up first and 10.
Right at the 30. Now Stafford. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Off the fake to Akers, here's Stafford.
Throw left side, complete to Kupp. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. If my calculations are correct here, I think that they are. He's now over 55,000 career passing yards.
But you did get a fine education in the Midwest, my friend, so I know that that happened, okay? I know those Butler Bulldogs very proud of what they sent out there, so I'm trusting your numbers. 55,000 yards? Wow. I mean, what more can you say?
Yeah.
Wow.
He was already in the top 10. Now he just keeps climbing toward the top.
Stafford's throw here, hauled in by Kupp. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
There's no overthrow when you run drag routes. You're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
On the handoff, it's Akers.
And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. Stafford looking to throw on third and one. Man open, it's Kupp, he's got it. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 32-yard line. Instead of a third and one run, they go pass and they get 12 yards out of it.
That's the third time in this drive that these two are connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's been off of big chunks of yardage as shown by that last play.
Now this offense really looking polished these first couple of weeks. Here's first and 10. On the give, this is Akers. get this one down to about the 20-yard line. That's a 12-yard gain now on back-to-back plays.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
And a flag down. I think one of the Rams linemen might have moved.
Offense.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. A false start backs him up 5. First and 15. Here's Stafford. Over the middle and complete to the tight end, Higbee. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. Looking to throw again on second down. Stafford looking underneath. He's got Akers. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 9 yards on the play there. That'll set him up first and goal.
They've certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it. And no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Throwing is Stafford. And he's got it. That's caught for a Ram touchdown. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams take the opening kickoff for the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. And in the red zone, I guess this is why you have a guy like that on your roster.
Without a doubt, if you have it, you use it because he's a guy that's going to win just about every time. Don't care what the coverage is.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes our score 17-0. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays.
And it ends with Cooper Kupp on the receiving end of the touchdown pass. Taken at the goal line.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half.
Lance and the 49ers now, first and 10.
At their own 22.
To throw, it's Lance.
Flushed out right. They'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Off the option, here's McCaffrey.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. They run with McCaffrey off the option. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Here's McCaffrey.
And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37.
Holding. Offense.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Give him 3 yards on the run. Now they'll need to drop something good here on 3rd and 13. So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count, and a 5-yard penalty ensues.
All start.
Offense. They accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards again.
So the false start certainly doesn't help matters as they'll try again now, 3rd and long.
And Lance now to throw.
And that will be incomplete. Here comes the 49ers punter now. As he'll punt it away for the 3rd time today. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. 37 yards on the punt and no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's a Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Going right back to Akers. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing on third down, Stafford. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And they have the football that will set up shop at the 33-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't he?
He really does. And I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame, and anytime you didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him this is what that time is, just what you're talking about, training him to understand this is the amount you have, make sure the ball's gone. Didn't happen in this case.
Lance with a tap forward on the jet sweep. Even with the good footwork, he'll be stopped just inside the 35. Second and 9. Lance returns it right back to Samuel. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Throwing now is Lance. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. We have played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's 49er football, but some ground to cover. They find themselves behind as we hit the fourth and final quarter. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Trey Lance, his first touchdown of the new season. And the 49ers are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Point after, right down the middle, and that'll cut the lead to 17-7. 49ers-7. The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The football going back to the Rams now. They've got the two-score lead. It looked though, they fumbled last possession, led to a touchdown. So while things look good here at this stage in the fourth, they got to be careful.
They definitely do, because they've actually brought them back into it, haven't they? They've given them hope once again. Their purpose on this drive, squash that hope.
First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
How about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Going to run the sweep here. This is Kupp. And he'll be brought down just shy of 45. From the 44, Stafford That's out to the flat for Akers.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
This offense on third down today, they've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Middle of the field to Jefferson. And he's going to have a Rams first down as they convert on 3rd and 3 with a nice gain of 7 yards.
And that pick up of first down, that's going to leave our heart because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating defensively. You're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or a takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
On 1st and 10, Stafford.
He'll get this one to Kopp, complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3.
From the 39, Stafford.
And a hookup here to Allen Robinson. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Off of play action. Here's Stafford.
And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10.
It leads to 2nd and 10.
Stafford looks to throw again. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is 3rd down and 8.
This one brought in by Jefferson. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 18. 5th catch of the afternoon, and that gets him a 1st down. Big hook up there, forced to throw on 3rd down. The connection's going to keep the drive alive and also keep the clock moving.
Yeah, and from a defensive perspective, didn't get a sack, didn't knock the ball free, didn't break up the pass. The clock keeps running on you. You're in a dire situation now.
From the red zone now, Stafford.
They'll set up the screen here to Akers. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play.
While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment.
To throw again on 2nd down. Stafford out route to Jefferson, and he's got it. And the Rams are going to have themselves at 1st and 4 as he's out of bounds at about the 7-yard line. They're looking to put this game on ice in the 4th quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show here.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
They'll run here with Akers.
Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more.
No gain on the play. Leads to 2nd and goal at the 7-yard line.
On 2nd and goal, Stafford being chased out left. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. So it's Rams football here as we get your reset. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. Stafford now to throw.
He'll get this to Akers out of the backfield.
And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. For the right hash here, should be an easy one. And his kick here is good. And that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So they settle for just the 3. McClellan right now, anything helps, trying to salt this from the line before.
Obviously, a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off. But it's still 8 up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. So Lance and the Niners down by 13, 1:45 to play.
It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance.
This one caught by Kittle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. From the gun, it's Lance. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Lance trying to urge his offense to go quickly. Meanwhile, Lance's throw taken in by Samuel. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth.
Lance.
And this one is incomplete.
Desperation time here. Lance winds up and lets it go for Samuel.
And incomplete on the deep ball. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 39-yard line. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, we saw the expression about slim and none. The slim just left town and now
they're down to none.
Yes, exactly right.
They've gone to the fourth quarter now in Dallas. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. If they hold on, a victory there would be their third of the year. The Rams go victory formation as they take the knee. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as it'll come with 36 seconds to go in half number two. Stafford down to a knee, and with it, he's going to ensure his guys a victory.